أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Last week we started what's going to be a series about what Hadith is. And I explained to you that the importance of Hadith is that it makes the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a historical prophet. Because we can find the details of all that he said and did in those books of Hadith. And also because we know what he said and what he did at different times, it allows us to bring the Holy Prophet into our lives. Because we know how he ate, we know how he slept, we know how he did various other things. So it allows us to bring him into our lives and really make him a teacher. Just like the teacher that stands up at school and teaches something, in the same way we can get from Hadith what the Holy Prophet would have done in various situations. Today I'm going to talk about the meaning of the word Hadith itself. And there is a difficulty in that Muslims have lost sight of the fact that just because a word of Arabic has one restricted meaning, they think it doesn't have any other meaning. And this leads to problems of many different kinds. Now, the Holy Prophet himself said that the best Hadith is the Quran. So if you're going to stick to the fact that Hadith means just the sayings of the Holy Prophet Muhammad and perhaps his actions, then obviously Quran is the book of God. So the Hadith, the word Hadith has to have different meanings. Well, it has many meanings. And I looked up in the Holy Quran different places where the word Hadith might be used and how it's translated by Hazrat Maulana Muhammad Ali into English. This is chapter 18, verse 70. قَالَ فَإِنَّ الطَّبَاطِنِ فَلَا تَسْأَنِّي عَنْ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى أُخْدِسَ from Hadith. You know, like do, did, done. It's the same sort of thing. It's a derivation. لَغَا مِنْهُ ذِكْرٍ. He said, if you would follow me, question me not about anything until I speak to you about it. So obviously, speaking or speech is one meaning of Hadith. I'll come to this later, the why this is the meaning. And another place, this is chapter 20, verse 113. Yatakuna or yuhdeso lahum zikr. So that it may be a reminder of faith for them, or a reminder for them. So here is again the word Hadith used in a slightly different way. Chapter 21, verse 2, Ma yatihim min zikram min rabbihim muhaddith. Again, a derivation of Hadith, muhaddith. There comes not to them a new reminder from their Lord. Here, the word Hadith is used to mean new. In fact, this, I suppose technically you could say, is the real meaning of Hadith. something new, as opposed to, because hadith is actually, hadasa is actually the opposite of something old. And when you say hadith means conversation or talking, what you're saying is it's something new that has happened, which wasn't there before. And in fact, Arabs were great ones for eulogizing their battles and so on, and victories and that. And the collection of poetry that each tribe had, in which they eulogized their victories over their enemies and so on, they were also called ahadith, because they sort of prominent events in that tribe's life or history, they reminded them of that. Here's again chapter 23, verse 44. Ba'dahum ba'dam waja'alnahum ahadith. Then we sent our messengers one after another, which is the part just before this. Whenever its messenger came to a people, they called him a liar. And then it goes on. Where are we? So we have made them follow one another, and we made them stories. So here is another meaning: stories. And two more. If I can find them. Oh, I can't find the one there. Oh, wait, this verse, which is chapter 93. Dr. Hamid used to recite this surah quite frequently. Wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddis. And the favor of thy Lord, proclaim. So proclamation, making widely known, is also a meaning of hadith. Here's another one, 52. Am yaquluna taqawlahu bal la yu'minuna falyatu bihadithin mislihi. Or they say he has forged, it, nay, they have no faith. Then let them bring forth like it, if they are truthful. The point I'm trying to make is that hadith, the word itself, has many different meanings, and it is used in the Holy Quran in many different ways. And as you would know, that Quran is actually a basic source for rules of grammar of Arabic, and also meanings of words of Arabic. Now, obviously, in one restricted sense, this word has come to be applied to sayings of the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Whatever he said, it was called a hadith. And it made me wonder why this word was picked. I mean, it does mean sayings and so on, but you know, there are many other words which could have been used. And I think, this is my own theory, that the reason is this: that generally Muslims believe, I mean, obviously we all believe God is eternal, but Muslims also believed that the Holy Quran was eternal. It was created forever. And they believed that its revelation, the form in which it took place, was that the Quran descended from on high to just above the earth. And from there, it was revealed to the heart of the Holy Prophet Muhammad piecemeal over a period of 23 years. So that was the old. It already existed. That was the old message, the message of God. Now what the Holy Prophet said and did, the way he explained it, was the new thing. So that is the reason I have come up with, that perhaps people, apart from the fact that, you know, it does mean sayings or conversation, it does also mean important event. So in many cases what he was saying was preserved because of its importance in relation to an event. But it occurred to me that perhaps the best reason that I can think of is the fact that, as opposed to God's conversation, which was old, this was the Holy Prophet's conversation, which was new. And hadith thus became the technical, in Islamic law, the technical name for the sayings of the Holy Prophet.